Alright, time for part 2. Welcome back.
Okay, let's do this.
Yes!
And we get a plasma.
Oh, plasma ammo.
Yes.
Yes!
Sweet.
I think what's kind of lucky about this this backpack is that every weapon got generated. Sometimes you don't see any weapon for like all the maps, which is very sad. Here we get everything.
Yeah, I remember the other one you recorded. It was like a plasma rifle at the start and no rocket launcher at all.
Yeah. And sometimes you never get a super shotgun sometimes, which is really sad.
Yeah, that is sad.
I'm always pretty generous, I mean, I got plenty on this. I usually have enough, even with
That's a nice thing, the sound to the plasma rifle.
Oh yeah, plasma.
It's so annoying, the original one. This one's much more, less noisy.
Oh yeah, very nice.
Yeah.
After 40 years.
It sounds better. Oh no, Ether.
Oh,
I guess it checks the thing for randomized like team. So there's different teams like tech, there's like Wolfenstein, there's psychedelic, which is retarded. And I don't know.
It is retarded.
This time it's mixed. I'm not sure because mixed usually mix all the teams in maps. Because the outside doesn't look like Wolfenstein. It looks like Doom 2, more like the texture of Doom 2. I think it's mixed, yeah.
Yeah, it's gotta be.
Yeah.
It didn't tell me the settings, so I couldn't guess. Holds. Actually, no, it's not Hitler on the wall, it's Spengler's avatar.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Spengler.
That was gross.
Genocider of Doom Crates.
Poor Doom Crates. That's why we didn't see any Doom Crates in like 6 months on Friday.
Yeah, because he went on a jihad pretty much to kill all Doom Crates. Why Spengler?
Goddamn Spengler. Doom Crates, think of the Doom Crates!
Yeah.
Think of their children,
Never again.
Families. Actually, make me remind of loading the skin pack I made with the Doom Crates.
Oh,
yes.
Doom
Crates again.
I remember that.
I always forget to load it. And usually mods have their own skin, so it doesn't work. I hope it works with the Mega Man mod.
Oh,
that would be pretty dumb.
Yeah, pink crates running around.
Yeah. Crates running around, doing flash kikus.
Yeah, exactly.
Flash kiku doing crates.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
And yeah, Penny Elemental right at the start here. And come back and I forgot it was there and it's this mayhem. So it's either you camp or you get this. Here I got this. Like, oh, I'll camp and nope, it was there again. Oh boy.
Yeah, they sure are annoying and fast. I mean, they're kind of annoying in normal too, but...
Not that
annoying. Silly.
Yeah, here I just keep... Yeah, like I said like 10 times already, I keep charging all the time, so it gets really fucking annoying.
Yeah, you're gonna run out of ammo.
Yeah, I think you killed it.
No, I still have plenty of ammo. Look, I have like almost 200 plasma ammo.
Yeah, well...
Yeah, I'm mostly using the lever, so that's way enough.
Oh.
Yeah.
And also, sometimes you see I have much less ammo, but that means I didn't, like, you know, took everything lever yet. Like, here up, plasma ammo.
Yay.
Boink.
Boink.
Don't have a backpack, though.
Yeah, I don't think I see a backpack in the world map, in the world pack. Which is pretty sad.
Yeah, well, you do have like 300 ammo cap for your plasma. And 200 for your chain gun, which is good.
Ah, could be better. I mean, usually when you play almost every map pack, you always have a backpack very early. And most maps has backpacks. Like in most Doom. Map was. Even in Doom 1 and Doom 2, there's backpacks everywhere on the secret and stuff. So we really used to have one, and here it's like, oh hey, I'm full on plasma ammo, so I should use it. So.
Yeah.
I got this.
I was also full on shells, so yeah. Oh. Most of the time I'm using weapons I have ammo for. The most. That's a trend I can't stop doing. Like, oh hey, I have a lot of ammo for that, I'm going to use that. Just when I said that, I actually use a chain gun for the swing barrels and a armor for it.
Kill me. Yeah, switch the rocket launcher for a bit. Yeah. Terrifying, thank God, but.
That's the thing. Yeah, I should use a shotgun. Nope. Use the shotgun.
You know, I really like the super shotgun in Doom 3.
In Doom 3?
Yep. Do you remember the Doom 3 expansion pack?
I never played the Doom 3 expansion pack. Only played
nope.
the one. Yeah, I never played it. Yeah, I should one day.
You did miss on the super shotgun. So, yep. But you didn't miss on much.
Yeah, I guess it didn't miss on much except that because.
Yeah.
I really don't remember much from Doom 3 except it was dark and every time there's a nymph spawning behind you. Every time. Every corridor was like,
time.
You're spawning behind you, okay, boom, okay. Oh, I'm spawning behind you.
From behind the walls.
Oh, yeah, zombies.
Well, here, normally, behind you.
Yeah, that's same, like, first three times, okay. But after 30 times, like, stop it. It's not funny anymore.
Yeah, ID Software has become a tech-based developer. They just make an engine and they just sell it.
Yeah, but that's not good at that.
Yeah, they're good at it.
Yeah, the engines are awesome, but I want some gameplay too. I want some old.
That's a problem. You know, that could be good if John Romero stayed. Like, you know, John Romero on his own. You know what he did. John Carmack on his own.
Yes.
Yeah,
Quake 2
games.
And Quake 4 and Doom 3. And yeah, if we still had both together, we could still have seen some awesome stuff. Oh yeah, time for Dead Sample. Obliged edition.
Oh, this sucks.
Yeah. Yes, like every time you do like map packs, map 8 will be a Dead Sample random generated map, which is very neat because Dead Sample is fun. Just range shooting, no key hunting, no bullshit, just a lot of rockets, a lot of plasma ammo, and let's go. This one is kind of big though because. So it's kind of easy.
Yeah.
Not ultra easy, but still, I have no trouble at all because it's so big. I can dodge around. Very easy compared to the normal Dead Sample. Standard Dead Sample. And thinking about
these enemies are still on fast, right? Because
look at them shooting all the time.
I mean, the Mancubis don't seem to be.
Yeah,
really
no, if they shoot, they either for like. Half a second and you keep shooting. Like, you can see them through. In less than half a second after they stopped shooting.
Yeah, I do see it now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In normal, they're there for like 1 or 2 seconds before shooting again.
That's the biggest thing you can notice in fast.
And with enemies like Shengunners and Armatrons, it's pretty deadly to have them shoot all the time, instantly. Okay, I'm just carving a path out of my way. But okay.
Yeah, you can't go back because then you're gonna get hit.
Yeah. Hello, what are you doing?
Hello.
Oh, and the sound from the art controls, I think it's the sound from Quake 3. Yeah.
Yep.
I recognize that.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I'm thinking about Quake, not that long ago, I played through every map of Quake 1 on Nightmare. I've never actually finished all the map of Quake 1 before.
Oh, so you did finish
neither.
Episode 4.
Because I discovered Quake 1 very, very late, like in the last 2 years. I never played it before. Mm. Because I never had the chance to.
I think I played it when it was new, but I never owned it, so I must have played the demo and then I never played the whole game.
Never found out about it, which is very sad because it's very good. Yeah, I don't know. Even if it's a game they ID made, it was like Strife. People were like tired because they say that. The thing, people in IDs hired a bunch of people and they started making, you know, maps and gameplay, and the engine wasn't finished. So every time the Conrad would add something and have a new version of the engine, you had to redo everything. And everyone got very like tired of that and. Was like a big event of people living in ID at this point.
Yeah.
And even with that and those stuff, like Romero wanting to leave at this point, they still made an amazing game. It's I love the balance and the weapons, enemies.
Yeah.
It's great.
it's pretty much perfect. It's pretty much the best FPS you can have. You should have it if you're like just an action type of person.
Yeah, I don't know why, but
it's really fast paced.
There's a bunch of switches you didn't press. Yeah, black.
Fuck it, everyone. Fuck it. But yeah, the balance is good. Like even melee enemies, you see, like the melee knights, so deadly because they can attack while running. It's just something simple like that.
Yes.
Something stupid. Our enemies are good for different situations. They're interesting. Weapons are useful. It's instant switching weapons makes the game very fast paced too.
It's very amazing in speedruns that they're.
It's pretty nice. So 100% quake down quickest, I think, got released like. I mean, got published on video less than a month ago, maybe a bit more than that. Like,
I haven't seen all of it yet, but I saw like half an hour or something. It was.
Half an hour as well. It's amazing. Look at that.
Yes.
Jumping everywhere. Wow. I mean, it's great because they did like separate runs for every map. But you know, that's a save every time. So, like, everyone tried to make the best for the first map. Then they take the save. No, they didn't take the save. What they did, they used like a port to start with exactly the same amount of health and ammo and stuff they had when finishing the previous.
Okay.
So they could start.
So they didn't change that.
No.
Because I think in the other compilation, they give themselves whatever they had to have for that.
That's what they did. That's what they said. They used a port to start with what they had.
I didn't mean that. I meant they could pick what they wanted.
Oh.
Like on map, you shouldn't have a rocket launcher. They, of course, didn't give themselves a rocket launcher, but they could give themselves full health and stuff. I'm not sure if they even did that before.
That's pretty weird. I mean, because you could, you know, cannot cheat. Oh, I'm just going to give me a few more rockets, just what I needed.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But I think they actually did something like that with the first. Breakdown, quickest or whatever.
But
I'm not sure.
The first wasn't. It wasn't 100% right. It was just.
Yeah, no. It was just
any percent.
Any percent. Complete as fast as possible.
100% is amazing because you know, you see them like throwing grenades away. They know that the grenades are going to kill the enemies.
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, I've thrown two grenades there. Whatever. And you see your enemy dying. You're like, okay, it was perfect.
That would be so annoying in Doom. Like. Okay, a Revenant, I shoot 3 rockets, then he survives or something, and
Doom is kinda random, in Quake, I don't think it's random.
No.
Yeah.
There's no randomness. I'm not sure about that, because I didn't play that much, actually, but it seems like it. Especially with the rockets. In Quake, you fire, like, a amount of rockets into, like, a grenade guy, he would die. Every time.
Yeah.
If you fire a Monkey, 3 rockets might kill it, might not. Mm-hmm. So, half the time you didn't fall. For one third of the time at least. Oh yeah, so Ash like dropped into a pit here. I pushed him. Okay, don't show.
You scared him.
Tori will see him again pretty soon. Back home. Hello?
Ready?
Oh,
nice.
There we go.
Quake is amazing and the multiplayer is frantic as well.
Yep.
Played some of that not that long ago.
And it's real 3D, oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
And yeah, gameplay wise, there's a lot of aids and stuff over other stuff, and you know, grenade guys done on up to you and over you and stuff like that, which is kinda funny.
Yep.
And secrets too. Secrets are pretty good sometimes. Yeah, I love Quake.
Yep.
I still love Doom more, but. Quake is an excellent successor to Doom.
It is.
Well, all those fights are also very, very funny, but it has a lot of flaws. And I cheated here, I just jumped out of the pit.
You coward.
Yeah.
You do the entire map pack at once.
Yeah, a lot of good ideas, like a lot of multiplayer game mods, like rocket jumping, a lot of clever stuff. Yeah, I don't know.
Well, let's not forget that Rise of the Triad came up with that.
Yeah.
Like, but bastard.
But just using the Warframe 3D engine was a big letdown because you could do that much with mapping. Like, you know, using push walls, using bumps, bumpers, using style system. You get so much of that. So you got some tricky stuff. Funny stuff, especially in the extreme of the triad, like, which is not very good, but sometimes you see like pretty clever use of traps and scenery. But it got its limits. Doom got its limits as well.
Yeah.
I mean, I miss the old style secrets. I mean, as in like stepping on tiles or pushing a button or just some crazy stuff. Hitting a trigger. I mean, these days, secrets aren't really that smart anyway. I mean, when I was playing Fear, secrets just right around the corner. You just have to take two steps. Waste a minute of your time just to get another of those vials or health vials or time slowing down. It's really lazy.
Yeah, it is.
But then again, that's the sacrifice you have to make.
I can't really talk that much about that. I didn't play the but most games don't even have secrets anymore. Like if you play like a
Call
of Duty. Nope. So there's no point of having secrets. Why? Yeah, you have infinite health.
You found a secret cache.
Maybe sometime you find
a secret.
That's it.
You can find it anyway.
Yeah, but I didn't play Halo at all. I played like one or two times in co-op, and that's it. So I can't really talk about Halo.
Neither do I.
Because Halo, you know, it's space for like modern FPS gaming. Basically.
Babies for.
Yeah, there weren't really any secrets in that. I guess there was some. Like overshield, whatever they were called, but no, there was no actual secret counter.
I mean, the last FPS I've seen, the most recent one that actually had some crazy secrets was just Synapso's Emergence, but that's because of Ritualistic is such an old company. They're really.
Did you play Painkiller?
Painkiller? Oh yes, Painkiller. But Synapso's came out like in 2006.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. But then again, that was their last game because they kind of went overboard. People just.
Okay.
They weren't really into those old games. I bought it, but no one else did. I don't know why.
I didn't.
It's
me. I put them out of business.
Yeah. It's all your fault.
Yeah.
At least you didn't pirate it, because that would have made Lost even more.
Oh yeah.
Well,
I didn't buy it as much money lost, because I didn't buy it.
People who did pirate it, they couldn't actually play the game because there was a bug there that couldn't be fixed. And it sort of prevented you from playing the game.
Yeah.
I mean, kind of like Arkham Asylum, except it was unintended. Arkham Asylum
unintended copy protection.
Unintended copy protection.
Reminds me of one thing, you know, Operation Flashpoint. When you parted the game, I think, you had the game slow down. The game was lagging like fuck when you had the game parted.
Well, they had this fade system in Operation Flashpoint, where it's like, what did it do? It did some crazy stuff with your game. I think it actually uninstalled it while you were playing and stuff like that. And I think it turned you into a bird in multiplayer or whatever.
I remember thinking of that because like we had only like the game once and we wanted to, you know, play it on LAN. And you had to, you know, get no CDs for that.
It was pretty unique at the time.
It's pretty clever. CD stuff, like, you know, I'm thinking for a game, like a strategy game. That when you started playing and you had the game cracked, you would every building and units would die after 30 seconds.
That's Valor 2.
Yes! Oh, yes. That was a funny way for them to, like, know, same thing.
Yeah, except it actually happens sometimes when you're playing the original. I don't know why it happened, but sometimes.
I remember playing Valor 2, but. I remember seeing.
You activated
the protection. Valor 2 too, I don't need it. Oops! What's happening? I have this problem. I don't know. I'm more like trying to do the most stuff you could do in 30 seconds. Like, let's try to do this in 30 seconds. Oh, nope. Not enough time.
Well, so yeah, if any of you people out there are listening, Tryouts and episodes, it was a good game. I mean, sure, just because Baldur's did a pretty lame LP of it, it's not that bad. Sin Episodes Emergence.
It was just cool to...
I'm sorry?
Are you talking about Blister?
Blister?
Yeah.
Yes, I think so. Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Sorry if I got your name.
So continue.
Yeah,
well, so he was kind of done, I think.
Oh.
So what are you going to say?
Oh, no.
You said that's a good game and people should try it.
Yes.
Okay, is it? I think it didn't go on sale.
Yeah.
I didn't saw a sale for it.
It's on Steam. I mean, the first game and the sequel are both there just for, like, I think $6 or something.
What did you say? 18?
I said the first game and the sequel are there. They're like $6, so it's.
Oh, six! Yeah, that's a good price. I wonder if they want on sale because they're already cheap. Yeah, $6 is
fine.
Oh,
you missed one kill.
Oh, not matter. Oh, and this map sucks balls. Ordnance of the map. No, this one's not too terrible. There's one which is very annoying later on.
Cover? What is that?
Yeah, I'm not playing Rainbow Six, I guess. I want to add in a few seconds.
Well, at least it's not Fear 3 or Rainbow Six Vegas.
Oh, yeah, sure. I was talking about Rainbow Six Vegas right there because I actually played it. As one of the second co-op, and it's a console. I mean seriously, the first like Rainbow Six game were amazing. Like, oh hey, you had tactical squad, like you make your mass, and you go there, and then something, and you had synchronized attacking certain rooms and stuff. It was amazing. You had a team of guys, and sometimes they could be like wounded between missions just with equipment doing different areas and stuff. It was extremely good, and then it became, oh hey, let's hide in a wall. Pew pew. Then a wall, pew pew. Frag grenade. And the only strategy is like, oh yeah, I'm going to open this door. What do I do? Do I go stealthy?
Oh no.
Do I throw
the
grenade?
Mexican lady took your dudes, your buddies. Now you can't leave without your buddies.
Oh, by the way, I'm doing that.
Uh oh.
Oops.
Ours will be your dude.
Oh.
I came beyond the crate just a bit late.
Oh boy.
And I totally failed this BFB attack. This one was very bad use of my ammo, but nothing.
You get that demon eventually.
Yeah. I did.
Yeah, you did.
We are talking about Rainbow Six. I really loved the first games when I was younger. It was like amazing. Doing plans and stuff and seeing them work. I would actually never play. I would just make a squad with just a guy. You know? Just use freely to do anything and make all the squads AI, and we just make the mission our AI. Just my plan, and it was amazing. Make your plan, see if it works or not. There was some
when
randomness,
the door,
like
from the
suppression of enemies.
Ah, that's all. Yeah, I just remember getting ambushed a lot in that game.
Yeah, but that's what the game about. You just try to ambush instead of being ambushed. So you know some guys, a few guys are patrolling in this area, you put everyone in place to like look into these areas. You wait a bit until they all die because of you guys stationed there, and then you say like next checkpoint and like move to the next checkpoint.
Yeah.
So on. But I mean, no. It was awesome. And yeah. Rainbow Six Vegas.
Yeah, I think I played the old one. And the new ones. I didn't like the new ones. It's just that,
I mean, they're fun, but
yeah, it's just that they're really generic.
Yeah, it's generic and it's not Rainbow Six.
There's not much to them.
Yeah, you just select weapon. Oh, we'll take the weapon because it looks cooler. You have like 12 clips. Like, what the fuck? You're carrying like 1,000 of ammo. You're killing 1,000 of guys and spending all the time being cover shooting and missing because you're behind cover.
Yeah. Covers and FPSs. I'm not really sure about that.
Yeah.
I think we realized that people camp all the time, so they, let's build a game around camping.
Yeah.
Let's be every that game around like camping. Fun. Actually, one thing I'm going to say about Halo doesn't use cover system.
Yes. Yeah. At least that's one good thing.
Can we know talking about Halo, because the guy that made Halo and Bungie, they made those games, they made Marathon, they made Myth, which is amazing games, and then they made Halo.
Yeah,
Halo isn't bad on itself, but they made the perfect game to make money.
I've been covering your myth free playing with the other druid. I'm sorry, I forgot your name. But it was yes.
What did you say?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I've been following the myth free LP. So
yeah, myth free LP. Yeah, it's pretty good. So game is not perfect, but the story and stuff, it's very interesting. I love that.
Yeah.
I've totally missed the myth games actually.
I miss them until, like, you know, the myth free thread.
Yeah.
Like, oh, hey, this game, what's that? Oh my god, I should watch myth 1 NP and, oh, this is amazing! And then I found, like, I played some multiplayer with Gun, it's excellent. Love that. co-op, or even, it's kind of the same for, like, Rise of the Triad except in LTS. Because he had a multiplayer, I mean, because he had lots of game mods and they were fun, like Myth, you have capture the hill, you have last man on the hill, which is not the same, you have to be the last one when the timer runs out. So it lets very, very awesome fight at the end of the time. You have capture the beacon, which is like a pole, you can move around, you have to keep it. Same way as those game mods.
It's pretty hectic.
Yeah, and
it's really exciting.
You can make
I thought it was capture the bacon, but I guess not.
No, it's beacon.
I misread it.
You don't capture capture beacon. Bacon, you eat it.
Yeah, but I mean the dwarves that want to capture the bacon, I guess, to eat it later. I don't know. It just made sense at the time. And
I
misread it and I didn't think about it anymore.
Because, you know, when
I was like, oh, doing
anything to you. It's like, oh, hey, bacon. I know that. That's good. Semi-friendly.
Tastes good.
Yeah.
One thing I miss about the old FPS games is leaning. It's much better. It was more dynamic.
Actually, it's in a few recent FPS games. You can guess which ones.
I do know
Black
ones.
Stalker. Black Ops.
Stalker, yes. Stalker.
Yeah, Stalker.
Yeah, they actually added that to Black Ops because people were whining so much about there not being any lean.
Really?
Really?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm still going to buy Black Ops right now.
Maybe not. Well, I'm gonna buy Black Ops because it has lean, huh?
It doesn't fix everything else in the game.
No, it's absolutely worthless to use.
Yeah. I mean, it's actually useful in single player when you just have one to be Caboo.
Ouch.
That's what I was talking about. Like, you have to stay inside here and clear everything you can see from there, and then you go outside. Because if you go outside and get shot by the monkey, the demons run to you and you can't really shoot with your rocket launcher, and you're being shot by them from the side by a revenant and other stuff, you die.
Yeah.
It is tricky. Like, even here, I'm taking, like, lots of damage. I won't die, though.
You will survive.
Yeah, because I just go outside and just... Let's go! Let's spam Brass Knight on everyone!
Of course. That is a winning tactic after all.
Yeah. When you have
That's a pro tactic.
Yeah. Shoot enemies until they die.
Shoot them until they die.
Yeah.
Instead of it.
Yes.
Yeah, because there's no Cyberdemon on this. And yeah, here you can see that it's obvious and it's fast, because you see so much projectiles in quick succession coming to you.
Yeah.
Which never happens normal.
Yeah, Barons never shoot that fast. They're usually pretty slow.
Yep. In Monkey Bay is kinda weird because as I always shoot them three times, so they always spam missiles when they three shoot.
Yeah.
Oh.
Ouch, ouch, ouch.
Yeah.
Ah.
God damn, it's me. Oh, it's nuts.
Yay, help.
Yay, help. Thanks.
Doop. Oh, so sound, I think it's from Rise of the Triad. Some sounds with the mod are from Rise of the Triad too. And the Recruiters Gibbs are from Rise of the Triad too as well.
Oh.
Just miss having bones and stuff appear on your screen. It was very funny. So we were talking about, you know, good games.
Good games in general.
I just wanted to talk about Myth again because I already found this amazing. Like, you know, the even the third game is not perfect, but it follows kind of the story. specify. The gameplay skin is the same, except you know, a few steps I kind of fail. Like if you watch an LP, there's the kind of few campaigns maps which are kind of horrible. Overall, it's the same game. You
know, yeah, as long as it's got dwarves with explosives, it can't be bad.
Yeah, physics engine. I mean, the first one came out. I don't know when it actually came out. Kind of early, like 1999 maybe, 1998. I'm not sure.
Not sure.
Yeah, but yeah, it's physics engine, 3D engine. It's usually sprites, 3D models, but that's normal for the time. And nuts. Yeah, it's amazing. I have physics everywhere, blow up stuff. You can have a lot of
fun. I do like the physics though. It's pretty fun.
Yeah, it's excellent.
Yeah.
Physics, you know, the fact that it was not the first game trying you know, the thing with no base building. An actual good gameplay, because if you had like mission with no base building in Command & Conquer and stuff, it would be terrible.
Yeah.
Because you had no way to avoid taking damage from most enemies, you know, 99% of the time, and it was very tedious. Here it's fun. And one game that
continues. Then you walk all your troops into a flame tank and you have to restart.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. And one game that continued this later was Ground Control.
Yep.
I love Ground Control. It looked amazing and the gameplay was very good too.
Yeah.
It lacked multiplayer DAO experience, like game mode and stuff. Which is pretty sad.
Yeah.
But it had something new for the time, DAO. It was multiplayer drop-in gaming. Like, you know, when you have a server of an FPS game, you can join during a game. And you could
that's
in one control.
Not normal for this.
Yeah. For Ground Control, it worked because since you didn't have any base and just had units that would drop, it worked.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ground Control, Ground Control 2, and a bit more recent World in Conflict are excellent.
Yeah, World in Conflict is a great game.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very good in multiplayer with different classes and units and balance.
Yeah.
The game.
It's very good looking too, and it's fun.
There was an LP of it not that long ago, made by, I think it's Isirar? Yeah, I think that's his name. Well, it's pretty good, he just subtitled the thing, so he would, like, take good scenes, views of the game, and it was pretty awesome.
Yeah, you can zoom in very far in that game, too. And they used pretty much those models for the cutscenes, too, so...
Yeah.
It was all in-engine, it's...
Pretty good.
It's pretty good.
Right, I think the video is going to end in a few minutes.
Yep.
No, not even minutes, seconds. So I guess thanks for watching if you actually watched this.
Yeah, I hope you did.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm heuristic. I'm heuristic.
Yeah. It's okay if you only listen to our voices. I can't blame you.
Yeah, it is that what. So,
well, thanks a lot.
I guess see you next time.
Bye bye.
Bye bye for now.
Bye-bye.